Right. Hi guys, welcome to part 5. In this lesson, I'm going to introduce you to quartal voicing to make your chord progressions or a pop chord progression a little bit more exciting. So with triads or with thirds, as we've learned so far, and at least in the first lesson, we learned a lot about thirds, right? To build harmony, thirds are not the only thing, right? There are all sorts of other intervals. So the quartal voicing concept builds harmony using fourths. So there are two kinds of fourths you can get. One is the perfect fourth, that sort of a sound, D to G. The other will be like a sharp four, which actually sounds a bit dissonant, but it actually works really nicely in a chord progression, as I'm going to show you. So we use these kinds of fourths. And again, you can extend the fourths. I'm going to just show it with a piano perspective. So that means you'll be able to play about three notes in this hand and one note in this hand, which is pretty much going to be the root note or the bass note of the chord, right? So let's get started. The first thing is, how do we form quartal chords, or how do we form these fourth chords? In the scale of D major, again, we are taking D major for this entire series. You could, however, do it on as many scales as you wish. Basically, two sharps, C sharp and F sharp. So to form a normal triad, what we did was moved up the third and then moved up another third to form the fifth. And that formed a normal triad. But the quartal chord still will use the notes of the parent scale or the diatonic scale. So in the case of D, the fourth would be G, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the diatonic fourth. And from G, I need to build another fourth. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? Automatically, it's a very open-ended sound, right? Right? But it's a really pleasant and very dreamy kind of sound as well. It has its own beauty. Try playing it everywhere and yeah. And then the next quartal chord will be E, A, and D, which will start from the E and then go E, fourth to A, and fourth to D. And like that, you will have seven quartal chords. If you take F sharp, F sharp B E, G quartal, G C sharp F sharp, A quartal A D G, B E A B quartal, C sharp quartal. Again, calling it quartal is a very unofficial terminology, because in theory, it's just the diatonic fourths of that scale or that mode. So if it was Dorian or if it was harmonic minor, in this case, I've taken the major scale. But in any scale, the quartal voicings come from the scale or come from the mode, right? So they are very dependent on the scale. Thus, quartal voicings can really bring out the beauty in the scale, almost as much as a melody in the song, right? So to show you guys how to use the quartal chord, as I talked about earlier, you had seven of them to use, right? D, G, C sharp, E, A, D, and so on and so forth. Now, the cool thing with the quartal chords, which I like to use in a lot of my music, is to take an existing chord, like D major has the root D in the D major scale. And let's try out all these seven quartal chords and use them accordingly. This is D, G, C sharp. Quite a dreamy or maybe eerie kind of sound, mystical sound. E, A, D. This is all over D, right? F sharp. G. A. B. And C sharp. So as you can see, over the D chord, all these voicings work really well, don't they? Similarly, over the E chord, the same voicings will pretty much sound really pleasant as well. Or on the F sharp chord. That's a very, very cool Phrygian sound right there. Right, so the quartal chords are really, really interesting to a point that there's almost no theory required to using them apart from how to form them diatonically, which you anyways do for forming triads and thirds, right? So normal triads seem to not work with every root note or with every bass note, but the quartal chords seem to work over everything. That's all the notes of the D major scale or any major scale. And that's also because the notes come from the scale. And then the notes are also separated by an interval, which is a fourth. That's a very open-ended interval. It's not an interval which is as resolved or committed like a third. Okay? So quartal harmony is something you can use, again, like all the other lessons in this series, to embellish a popular chord progression, a normal 1-6-2-5 or a 1-5-6-4. So let's just see how it's used in action. I'm going to go back to what I did earlier, which is the 1-6-2-5, and just show you options. And again, like I said earlier, over every chord, whether it's major or minor, you can play a lot of these quartal voicings. So I would suggest step one, write down the scale and write down all the possible quartal chords with it. And then while you jam, you can choose which quartal chord works for you, works for the song, works with the singing melody in mind, and generally works for the vibe of what you're trying to create, right? So if I play D now, again, my progression originally was D, B minor, E minor, and A major. We've all heard that, haven't we? So now, so check that out. That is D major with B, E, A. So with this, I get the 13, I get the 9, and I get the 5, which is normal. I could also voice it like this, which where I get the 3rd, I get the 13, and I get the 9. So you can try out whichever voicing. I've just written down a couple, but you could try out what works best for you. And similarly, to play the B minor chord, I quite like that, or it's quite a, that's real, that's quite a very mystical, or a, also quite an uplifting sound in my opinion. So again, the choices are yours, guys. You have to decide which one to use. And for E, I've chosen this shape. Or you can even do an ADG. And these are all one of the 7 quartal chords which you guys would have anyways needed to write down, right? There are 7 quartal chords in each key. And finally, for the A, again, focusing a lot on the 13, which is the F sharp, and also the flat 7, which is the G. So I really like that voicing. You can also bring that 13 down to a flat 13 and some create some really interesting vibes. Okay, so in short, you basically take a 4 chord progression, play the bass notes in your left hand, and in the right hand, choose whichever quartal chords among the 7 you've already written work with the progression. So we've written it down for D. If you haven't, please write it down right now. And also, the kinds of quartal voicings you choose should not be random. It should be based on something you really enjoy and connect with. Also, something which doesn't clash with the singer of your band or the improviser. That is also very important. And like a lot of the other parts in the past which we've done, this is the 5th part in the series, but like any other part, if you take any chord, let's say you take the B minor played like this, That's with this quartal. This can really inspire your melody, the singer in your band or yourself or whoever's making the melody to actually sing on these notes. Of course, you can sing the root. So on, or so perhaps you can also make a few suggestions to your singer if you're working with a singer to kind of latch on to those notes, because ultimately I see the vocal line or the melody line at the top end of everything. It's sort of like the fruits or the flowers of a tree. That's ultimately what makes it all complete, like the point of the tree. So you want to tell your singer what to do, or you want to guide your singer as to the notes which are available, and then the singer may also have options of their own. So you could then change the quartal voice accordingly. That's what makes it a very free and a very open-ended sound. And advantages of this quartal voicing are also that it doesn't clash with the rest of the band. It's a very open-ended sound. And the advantage I find in using it is it makes my music, which could be very simple. It could just be like we just played 1-6-2-5 or 1-5-6-4, whatever. It could make it very dreamy or mystical or eerie if you're going for that sort of a vibe. Something more filmy or something more like not so popular vibe, right? So this is used by a lot of musicians. We'll try and put a link in the description. You can check that out, with a lot of musicians out there, some classical guys and some jazz guys who use this voicing in their music. You should definitely check out the links we've sent out. And last but not least, let me show you the same song which we've been doing all through, Let It Be by the Beatles. We've really messed it up, haven't we? So the same chords, D, A, B, G. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me. And of course, with the quartal. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me. I like that sound. Very plain, right? Well, I find myself, B-E-A, in times of trouble, oh, Mother Mary comes to me, oh. You can always change it around. Remember, there are 7 options you can play around with. So yeah, it's quite a weird thing for some of you who have not heard this, because normally you have a triad, there are 3 inversions, right? And now you have like 7 quartal chords, so that's 7 ways of playing all the 7 chords, right? So I hope I didn't confuse you, but hopefully gave you some new stuff to try out. So as always, thanks for watching this video, and also for those of you who watched all the 5 parts, thanks for your time and patience. And there is an elaborate set of instruction material or study material which we have in our description. We urge you all to click on the link and download yourself a copy. Also share the video with your musical friends or not so musical friends and get them to be more musical. And as always, keep watching and keep subscribing, and what else? Stay tuned, I guess. Cheers.